Oh my gosh.
I can't believe all this time I've been using my refractometer wrong.
I
I
think you're
cannot
doing it
believe
wrong.
it. And what did you know about? What do you mean you knew it?
Well, you're using a refractometer and you hadn't done the wart correction factor. You got to do that with the hydrometer before you use it to measure wart with.
What does that mean? I mean, what are you talking about even? I don't even understand what you mean.
Well, because they're made for fruit juice. They're not made for wort from beer. All right?
Well, how come you didn't tell me this before? I mean...
Well, you're one of them big YouTubers. I figured you'd have known this stuff already, so I don't know.
Well, clearly you know so much, so do you want to come teach this thing or what? I mean...
No, you go on ahead and do your little tutorial. I'm just going to sit over here and have a beer.
Well, at least I'm smart enough not to drink out of my spit cup. Really, all jokes aside... The wart correction factor was something that I did not really know about at all until somebody made a comment on a Facebook post that I made. So, you know, once I found out about it, then it's like, you know, I'm off to the races, diving into it, figuring it out. What is it about? How does it work? So I want to show you how to get your wart correction factor for your refractometer. Now, you are going to need a refractometer and you are going to need a hydrometer. Now, I do like the Brewing America brand, and the one that I like specifically is the one with the thermometer in it, because it actually will tell you what the temperature is of your sample. So then you can put that in the calculator, which we're going to be talking about a little farther on down the road, and then that will help you adjust the reading on your hydrometer so you get an accurate reading on it, and then you can compare it to the reading on the refractometer. So what you need to do is you need to take a reading from your wart and take a reading with your hydrometer and then take a reading with your refractometer, and you put it in a spreadsheet, which I'm going to show you here in just a few minutes, and I'll have a link for everything down below. This is like a $17 refractometer, and then I'll have a link down below for the Brewing America hydrometers as well. So, you know, what you need to do is take your sample, get your reading on your hydrometer, and then take your reading on your refractometer, you put it in the spreadsheet, it gives you a correction factor. Now, that is basically a real simple explanation of it, and what I wanted to do is, they say you should track it over about 30 different brews, and that's what the spreadsheet that's from Brewer's Friend website has on it, is 30 different cells you can put information in. But to do an initial calibration, if you don't have any wort handy, what I have done is I actually took some DME and about 150 milliliters of water, which will fill these up and leave a little bit of sediment in the bottom, as I'll show you here in just a minute. I did three samples, put 3 teaspoons in the first one, 3.5 teaspoons in the second one, and 4 teaspoons in the fourth one of DME. Shake the heck out of them and let them sit for about a half an hour or so. And then what you want to do is you'll pour off the liquid from those samples into your hydrometer and keep track of, you know, you'll track that as you go along. And so let's do that. I'll show you. I've got 3 samples here that I shook up earlier, and they're not 100% clear, but that's not really a big issue at all. Then I like to just fill it from the jar, and then when the hydrometer starts to float, you know you've got enough in there. So we'll do our first one here, and let's see where we wind up at. Looks like 1.040. So now, one of the things too is a lot of the adjustment calculators are for bricks. Now this particular refractometer that I'm using measures bricks and specific gravity. So that's the nice thing about that. I don't have to do any kind of conversions. If you have one that doesn't have bricks reading on it, I'll put a link for a tool to be able to adjust specific gravity for this calibration. So let's take a look at the reading here. And so this reading is showing 1.049. So, I mean, you can see there's quite a bit of a difference between the 1.040 and the 1.049 that this is reading. So if I were checking this wart off of this, I would be getting a false reading. So I'm going to put those numbers up on the screen over here. And then as we go through this, I'll just leave them there. And then when we go into the spreadsheet, I'll show you exactly, you know, we'll keep those numbers there and we'll input those in, and I'll show you that wart correction factor. So let me get the rest of these all done up, and then we'll jump into the spreadsheet and we'll take a look and see what that looks like. Okay, it's actually 1.058, and this was 1.068. It's a 1.0 for this. So this is off. So it's off quite a bit there. All right. So that one is 1.042. And this is showing 1.054. So we got a pretty good disparity there. All right, now one last thing I want to take a look at is the thermometer on here. And these readings are all 74 degrees. So that was the last number that we actually needed, was a 74 degrees. And we've got all of our numbers over here from the samples. And so now let's go into the computer and I'll show you how to input all that stuff. And then we'll come up with that wart correction factor number, so you know what to put in your software, so when you take your reading with your refractometer, it is accurate. So let's jump in the computer.
Y'all gotta do me a favor. You gotta hit the like button. He just keeps going on and on about it. Like, why don't nobody hit the like button on my videos? I don't understand. So help me. Oh,
hey, why is this camera? What are you doing? All right, real quickly, before we get started on the computer thing, one of the things that I forgot to mention was calibrating your hydrometer. You want to calibrate your hydrometer when you get it, and really before you do any batch of beer, and that is with a drop of distilled water, and you just make sure that it's zeroed out at the bottom. One thing that they do mention in this spreadsheet, and I'll have all the links to everything down below, is that they recommend that you do samples of a large beer, like a beer that's, you know, 1.083 or 20 bricks to start out with, which kind of makes sense because you're normally measuring fruit juice, which, you know, wines are higher than alcohol generally than most beers are. So they recommend doing that. I'm going to show you what I did and the results that I had. So, and one of the things that I forgot to do when I was taking the measurements was measure everything in bricks, which is fine because that is actually like a happy accident, a little Bob Ross there, happy accident where I can actually go in and show you the calculator or conversion tool that is on Brewer's Friend. So there is a conversion tool here, and basically what you do is you can convert your specific gravity back to bricks. And so the first sample was 1.049, and that puts us at 12.1 bricks. So let's go ahead and put that in the spreadsheet. And that was 12.1 bricks. And then our hydrometer was 1.040. And then you'll see it gives you the factor over here, the adjustment factor. Let's do the next one. So the next one was the refractometer was 1.068. So let's see what that is in bricks. All right, 1.068. And that is 16.6 bricks. So let's hop back over in the spreadsheet and put that in. 16.6 bricks. And the hydrometer reading was 1.058. So the next one was 1.054 for the refractometer. So that was 13.3 bricks. So we'll put that one in. And the hydrometer sample was 1.045. I did recheck the hydrometer sample on the last one, and it was actually higher than what I originally said in the video there. I just found out that, you know, I spun it again, and there was a little bit of particles that were hanging on it and stuff. So I was able to measure it again, and it was 1.045. So this will tell you your factor is 1.1872, which is kind of high. I mean, I'm not surprised by a really cheap refractometer. You can spend more money on them probably and get a little bit more accurate one. The one I bought was $17. So one of the things you can do with that is whenever you have that figure, you can actually put it like in your software. So the correction factor that we had on that was 1.1872. So we'll put that over here, 1.1872. And then if we put our bricks from, let's say, the first one, which was 12.1, that should actually give us our corrected factor, which is 1.041. So that is what the actual reading was on that. And that is with using, actually, we're not calibrating the refractometer, but so by using the brick scale, you can check and see how accurate your refractometer is and put that number in your software so that you can make sure you get the correct reading. Now, this is just really like a high level overview of it. If you want to do more, you can do like they did here where you have that high DME, was like 1082 was the hydrometer sample. And then they went through and did like four or five different ones. I'll leave that up to you. They definitely recommend doing like multiple batches. And I would suggest, you know, making this part of your routine for probably 10, 15, 20 batches, something like that. And then you can start to dial in that wart correction factor even more. But what I'm giving you here is a good starting place. If this video was helpful to you, thumbs up is always appreciated. You can click on the video right here for more information on this type of thing, or the video down here. This has been Brian for Short Circuit of Brewers. We'll see you on the next video.